Hey guys, Ernest Langdon from Langdon Tactical with the Beretta Training Series. Today we're going to talk about proper trigger control and focusing on the right things. Trigger control is often the biggest problem that we have on hitting the target. You can pull the trigger however you want as long as you keep the sights in alignment with the target. And often what we find, what we're doing with the trigger finger is what creates the problem, misaligning the sights. One of the issues that I have as a trainer out there is people tend to focus on the wrong part of the trigger control. What am I talking about? It is often taught to pull the trigger, hold the trigger to the rear while the gun cycles, and then slowly reset that trigger after we've aimed the gun in. The problem with that is the wrong part of the trigger press is slow and controlled, and it sets you up or puts you in a situation to anticipate that next shot. We're doing a real slow reset, and as soon as we feel or hear the gun reset, we're ready to jerk that trigger again and misalign the gun. What you should be focused on when that gun fires and cycles is getting off the reset of the trigger and back to the prep point, taking the slack out so that we can precisely press the trigger correctly, slow and smooth to the rear. So again, pull the trigger, the gun cycles, get off the trigger, back to the prep point, and slowly press the trigger correctly. That's gonna allow you to shoot the gun rapidly and accurately at moving targets and while you're on the move. One of the things that causes problems is when we pull the trigger, people have a tendency to ride that trigger forward because they want to have minimal trigger finger movement. They only want to move it the minimal amount, and theoretically that makes you faster. The issue that happens is we often don't move the finger far enough when we start trying to shoot really rapidly, and we get what we call trigger freeze. We come off the trigger and then we come back, and sometimes we don't reset the trigger. People ask, should I break contact with the trigger or not break contact with the trigger? And some trainers will teach you to stay in contact with the trigger the entire time. The problem there is when I shoot really fast, I may break contact with that trigger. And in my opinion, that's okay. Here's why. If my finger breaks contact with that trigger, I've guaranteed that I've reset the mechanical mechanisms in the trigger mechanism, and I'm ready to take another shot. So I know some of you are saying, wait a minute, I've been told to release that trigger slow and precise while I'm aiming the gun. Why do I not want you to do this? Think this through. If you are in a life or death situation, you're moving, the target's moving, are you really gonna hold the trigger to the rear while you release it slowly trying to aim the gun in? No, you're probably not. You're gonna have a moving target that you need to shoot rapidly, and what that means is you need to get back to the important part of the trigger press, and that is pressing the trigger to the rear, not releasing it slowly. Remember guys, release that trigger, get back to the prep point. Train hard, stay safe, and win the fight.